Dale, the historian.
Robert Schmidt.
Dale Bitsch.
Glad to meet you, Dale. And you probably can tell me a lot more about this than I'll ever know. Of course, this is stuff that was done for you guys a long time ago.
I remember this.
Yeah. Well, this is the 300.
Mm-hmm.
The one that's...
I remember 300.
It's going to have to be rebuilt. We realize that.
Mm-hmm. And we had, since you were here last, we had running.
Yes, you did. Well, when they had the fire here, and then they retubed the boiler, then you was running it in the 80s, right?
90s, yeah.
In the 90s. And since then, the boiler's rushed out of the bottom.
Yeah.
I got to see the boiler over here, and I got to see the running gear. And eventually, they said they were going to build another boiler in Texas and have it done. I'm going to make sure you get some of these pictures.
Thank you.
That's original picture. I'm making them up like this. Here's what I'm doing. I'm doing them up like that. There's one of Dad running it, and there's the picture up there. I'll make sure you get some of these for you guys down here.
Appreciate it. Thank you.
Yeah, because it's a lot of history.
That's here.
Nope. This is out Browns Road. This was down in Alton.
That was in Alton. Okay.
That was in Alton at Fraser's Plant.
That's right.
Concert that he's had down here.
He just took it down this way.
Yeah, that's what he said. But this was up at Browns Road up there, and then... up in St. Louis. That picture there. But all these other ones, just like these, I acquired these, you know. Here's another one of, that's the only colored picture I've got of the engine, by the way. You might want to show that to this young fella here. And I'm trying to find a better colored picture of it. We got family members, they up in Michigan, and they're trying to look through all their stuff and try to find me some colored picture. Because I'm going to do Dad's engine up exactly like this. This O-gauge one.
Okay.
But see, that's at the shop. And there at...
That's at Brown Road.
Yeah, Brown Road. Here's a car that he built. There's one of the old wooden cars. There's a train trestle up there. You probably got guys a lot of these pictures anyway, somewhere.
I don't know if I've seen that exact picture, but...
you got the car still here.
It was built by St. Louis Blowpipe, but he may have helped involved with the construction of it.
Yeah, he did. And he built that tank car, too.
Yeah, I think that has his name on it.
Right.
His name on it.
Right. And then he built some flat cars back in them days, too. Mm-hmm. Some of them old steel flat cars. These are just up the road in St. Louis.
Yeah, this signal's right down here.
It's still down there. Wonderful. And look at here. There's that beautiful thing that Missouri Pacific built. Here's one of the gondolas. Here's your beautiful caboose that got burned up when Dad's engine got burned up.
Yeah, we need to rebuild that. They started on the second one.
I can't make out the number. I don't have my glasses on. That's 45, it looks like.
And 45, this is number 151. That's the first car.
Okay, it's here.
Yeah, that's here.
Yeah, so is this one. And here's the 180, here's the 171, and here's Dad running the 400 at that time. And of course, this is back up here at Browns Road, you know, mm-hmm. when they had it up there. This is back in 1960. This was down in Woodrow, by the way, that one. But this is all, I've got to come mixed up here a little bit because of the showing to the guys here lately. But there's a going across the trestle up there at Brown's Room. And this was down in Wood River when he ran it at, it was a boat company down the edge of Wood River. It had a property back there. That's when he first ran it over there. And then he found out in Illinois you had a hard time getting the boiler certified every year to run it. So that's why they brought it to Missouri. Because you guys don't have that problem like we did in Illinois. And of course that's when back in the 60s when they brought it. I got pictures when they actually transported it and everything over here. And then when they brought it down here.
That's the shop at Brown Road.
Yes, yes, definitely.
That'd be 50s.
Yeah, right.
50, okay.
Yeah, 59 and into the 60s, 61, because he had it over here in Woodrow around the sea.
Well, we were only there to 59, so.
Okay. So 60s, they had it down
the interim.
That's down in Wood River. That's his setup. I got a lot of pictures of all that place here. Here's a whole bunch of pictures of that.
That's okay.
See, what I'm trying to get somebody to do for me, just like this.
Yeah.
this is me running that. This is my youngest brother. He's 58 years old now. I'm 71. But this was up near their home up there in Alton. They built this in 1947. See? And it had a four-cylinder Hercules motor in it.
What gauge was this?
Gauge, I don't know what the width of that thing
was. It looks like it was
almost
bigger.
24 inches, I think.
As I say, it looked like it was bigger than 12.
Okay. Yeah, this is 1947 when he was building it in their driveway. And there's a four-cylinder Hercules motor. And this is when they first started running it down to, they called the Alton Expo. I never did run the steam engine. I just, you know, and time goes on and stuff like that.
I've only run it once or twice.
Have you? Bless your heart. A lot of good memories.
Yeah, it wasn't one that I normally ran, so.
Yeah. But what I'm going to do, I'm going to blow these up bigger and get them blowed up bigger, because I found that people will do it for me now for about 37 cents a copy.
Oh, okay.
See, I've been wanting colored pictures bad. I blew these all up, all of these pictures I have.
What we've been doing lately is we've been scanning these. With a flatbed scanner instead of a computer and digitizing them.
Yeah, and that's what I did with these. And then took the Walmart and he did these for $4. It's lost one letter. It's lost one letter off of it. See here? It's lost an R here and a period here. I could probably get them put back on there for you before I give this to you.
Okay.
Because I know people I can get that done. But I'd love you to have this stuff. It means so much to me. It does. And to you guys.
Yes. Well, we've been trying to look for, we try to figure out what to do with the builder's plate.
When the train got burned up that time, when they had melted so much stuff, they had no plans or nothing to reproduce it. And Mom, she had sent pictures to you guys. I know that's the only thing they had left.
You give me these to us?
I want you guys to have them.
Okay. I have a use for them already. Mike? Look what you got for your caboose.
You got it. You got it. Now, if we only could make a twin of that thing.
We have to.
Oh, you're kidding me.
No. These went on the 300. These were on the tender of the back of the 300.
And you know what I've also got?
He's got
I
don't know.
I
you,
got
may
the
have
females.
You may have to make a new bracket for those.
See, these were on the tender, on the back of the tender of the 300.
Okay.
I know they were.
Oh, gorgeous. Thank you. Yep. And those do have a working home.